Now die hybrid cross. Dihybrid. Mendel has also considered two characters in a pea plant during his hybridization experiment. So, when two characters are considered in the hybridization, such cross is called as the dihybrid cross. Mendel considered two characters in the seed of the pea. One is the seed color and seed shape. Two characters are there, color and the shape. So two colors, one is yellow and this yellow is represented by the genotype capital Y. Let me discuss about genotype. Yellow and green. While the seed shape, it was round and wrinkled. The two type of the colors. One is the yellow color and the green color. Another round and the wrinkled. So he made hybridization in a such way as the seeds parents round hello and other is wrinkled green. Wrinkled green. These are one character is round. It is controlled by the capital Y and the capital R and the hello is capital Y. Round is the dominant, so it is represented by genotype R, while yellow is also dominant, so it is represented by the capital I. And here wrinkled, it is represented by the small r, and the small y and the small f. These are the genotype, these are the parents, and the cross is made. And here they produce the gametes. Gametes are produced. These are the homozygous. So they will produce only one type of the gametes, capital R and the capital Y. And here gametes produced by them will be small r and the small y. They will produce the gamete and they come together into the F1 generation and they make capital R, small r, capital Y and the small y into the F1 generation. And this is capital R means round and Y means yellow. So phenotype will be round yellow. Phenotype round yellow. And when self-pollination is made into the individuals of F1 generation, means selfing, that is the capital R, small r, capital Y and small y. Selfing is made, then they produce the gametes, male gametes and female gametes, both type of gametes will be produced. They will produce capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y and small r, small y. Four types of the gametes will be produced. Four type of the male gamete will produce and four type of the female gametes will be produced. This is the male gamete and this is the female gamete. And the same way female gametes will also be produced. So here they will small r, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y and small r and the small y. These type of the gametes will be produced and there are the 16 types of the possibilities. And here in first you see capital R, capital R, capital Y and the capital Y. Second, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y and here capital R, capital R, small r, capital Y and small y and here capital R, small r, capital Y and the small y. So four type of the genotypes are there. Four type of the genotypes are there. Let us discuss about the phenotypes. And here capital R, capital R, capital Y and the small y. And here capital R, capital R, small y and the small y. Here small y and small y will be there. And the capital R, small r, capital Y and the small y. And here capital R, small r, small y and the small y. So here four types of more genotypes. Let us discuss about the phenotypes. And here capital R, capital Y, small r and the capital Y. And here capital R, small r, capital Y and the small y. And here capital R, small r, capital Y and the small y. In this case small r, small r, small r and the capital Y and the capital Y. And here small r and the capital Y and the small y. In this case you see capital R and the small r, small y and the small y. And here small r and the small r, capital Y and the small y. And here small r, small r, small y and small y. So here you see 9 individuals are there. nine type genotypes are produced into the Yak2 generation. Nine type of genotype are produced. Now we can see the phenotypes. Phenotypes we can see. So we can write the name. Number one is there. It will be easy for us for the writing. Number two is there. Number three. Number four. Number five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and the 16. So, first we see, capital R, capital Y. R means round. So, first, capital R. Means first we see round and yellow. So first will be this is genotype and this genotype will be round and yellow. So first will have round yellow and second we see capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. Second, will also be round and arrow. Third, capital R, small r, capital Y. Here you know that capital R is dominant, so this suppress the expression of this small r. So will be round and here, since both are the Y, so they will produce arrow. So third, will also same experience. And fourth, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So fourth will also be the same possibility. And here, capital R, capital Y, small y. So fifth will also have the same round shape of the seed will be round and color of the same seed will be yellow. So fifth and sixth you see, capital R and small r and capital R that will cause the one is second round. Round is here and six small y. Small y means green. Round green. So six will be and 6 point will be round green. And seventh you see R capital R and small r capital Y small y. So here 7 will be round yellow. 7 will be round yellow. Now see 8 capital R small r capital Y capital R small r small y small y. So this R means round and small y means green. So there will be 8. 8 will have the round and the green. Now 9 you see capital R in this way we have to write capital R small r and capital Y capital R. In this way we have to write. So capital R so here 8 this 9 this will also be round yellow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now see 8, 9 and 10. 10 capital R capital Y capital R small r capital Y small y. So 10 will also have the same possibility. Means this will also round yellow. 10 and 11, you see here, R it is given here, small r means wrinkled yellow. Third is wrinkled, then 11. This thing, small r is there, this small r means wrinkled, and yellow means here. So wrinkled, yellow. means this will be number 11. Brinfield yellow. This will number 11. Now 12. Small r capital Y, small y. Small r means that is the Brinfield yellow. Brinfield yellow means 12. Will also be Brinfield yellow and 12. 13. Capital R small r, capital Y small y. So 13 will be round yellow. Now see 13, 14. Capital R small r, small y and small y. Means capital R is there, so they will be round and small y means they will be green. So round green. Round green means 14. And 15, small r, capital Y, small y means Brinfield yellow. This will be which number? 15. 15 will be and 16, small r, small y, this will be Brinfield green. 4, Brinfield green, its number is 16. So now these are the genotype. These are the genotype. Now see what number of the round yellow. Round yellow. This is the. These are the genotype and phenotype. This is genotype. This is different genotype and this is the different genotype and these are the phenotype. Correct phenotypes. Now ratio, see what ratio will be there. Round yellow, what number? 3. 9 is 9. 9 plants, 9 seeds are round yellow and a round green. 3. And here wrinkled green. 3 and wrinkled, wrinkled yellow 3 and wrinkled green 1. In this way, in the dihybrid cross, they get the ratio into the 9:3:3:1. So, in dihybrid cross, we get the 9:3:3:1. So this ratio can be derived as 3 round ratio 1 Brinfield, 3 round ratio 1 Brinfield multiplied by 3 yellow 1 green. So if we multiply them, 3 means 9 round yellow, 3 round yellow ratio, and here 3 one job, 3 Brinfield yellow means 3 Brinfield yellow. Brinfield yellow here. And again we make multiply, then we get 3. This will be round and green. 3 round green, and again ratio 1 green. In this way we can also find by multiplying 3 round ratio 1 bracket by 3 yellow and in 3 1 green. This is same 3 of the same of the round and 1 bracket, and here 3 yellow and 1 green, and by multiplying them we are getting 3 round yellow. If we multiply this way, 3 multiplied by 3 3 jar 9 round yellow, and 3 3 1 jar 3 3 bracket yellow here, bracket yellow here, and again multiply by this one is the so 1 3 1 jar 3 round and the ground round green here, and only one round here, only one wrinkled green here, only one wrinkled green, sorry, one wrinkled green. So in this way we are getting the 9 ratio 3 ratio 3 ratio 1. So here we are seeing that the GR, capital R gene, governs or the controls the shape R, capital R, that the shape round, and while Y controls the color, and here they came here, and here into F1 generation during the formation of the gamete. During the formation of gamete, 50% of the capital R and 50% of the small r segregate from each other. In the same way, 50% of the capital Y and 50% of the small y become segregate from each other. So in this way, their segregation, their separation do not depends on the segregation of other genes. So on this basis, Mendel proposed the third law of the inheritance, that is called as the law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment. So law of independent assortment. Law independent assortment. Law independent assortment may be explained only by the dihybrid cross or the trihybrid cross. It may not be explained by the monohybrid cross. So this law states that according to this law, according to this law, find two pairs of traits, find two pairs of traits are combined or combined in a hybrid combined in a hybrid segregation of one pair of characters, segregation of one pair of characters is independent of other pair of character. So in this way, this is the inheritance of two genes we have completed. Thank you.